Hi, my name is Mónica Rodríguez and I'm a doctor, a medical doctor, and I'm working in Buchinger Wilhelmi Clinic in Marbella in Spain. And I'm here because I work as part of the medical staff, treating the patients, having in mind what is the importance to be in part of our lives, giving a rest in our immune system, how fasting is a very important way to do it. Because nowadays we're having a lot of chronic conditions we call low-grade inflammation, and behind that we have problems in the immune system, in the metabolic system. So we think that definitely is quite important to treat patients having in mind this fasting. Basically, what we have now with a very big part of the society is that we, because of the lifestyle, we change a lot. Imagine that in the past, we were made for different things. We were made just for wake up in one moment of the day and then go for hunting, go for gathering the food, and then we can eat and we move a lot. More or less, we say that in the past, we moved around 8 kilometers a day, and we have day and we have night for all our activities. But nowadays, what we have is days, very long days, with more than 20 hours of light, because we have artificial light, and we have many activities that we have, not only physical, cognitive as well. So what happening is that we make that our immune system is always working, because we don't move, so it creates a lot of inflammation when we eat every day, many times in a day. So what we're doing is acting directly in the first barrier that we have in our, for example, the guts, the intestine, in our skin, in our airway. So if we eat continuously, we are attacking our immune system. Our immune system is working a lot. So when we have that activity, we create some specific substances, we call it cytokines, that go they go everywhere in our body. So we need just to calm down that barriers in our intestine. How can we do it? Reducing the food. And if we can fast periodically, what we have is that like boost for our immune system, the immune system. In that way, we reduce the different ways that we have chronic conditions. For example, nowadays we have metabolic syndrome in many patients with high glucose, with obesity, with hypertension. We have another very important topic right now is stress. We have chronic stress. So all those things create inflammation. And if we don't move our body as in the past, so we create a perfect state of inflammation. So that's the idea. We recommend not only fast. What we do here in the clinic is recommend to change the lifestyle, the habits. It's quite important, not only during the stay. We prefer that the patients learn many things, and they, when they return to their countries, they continue with that, because it's quite important. Basically, moving, as I mentioned before, eating less times, just having one or two meals, that it's physiological, is what we did. And if we sleep, we respect the night for that, because we need to recover our body. If we could rest at least 12 hours of no eating is quite important. It's something that is physiologically. So we recommend to do that. And of course, reducing the stress. And another very important topic that we are very concerned is about the rhythm, the biorhythms, because we don't sleep. We have a lot of insomnia. We think that is the big pandemic in these moments. We don't sleep in correct way. And it's because of that, because we have a lot of activities. We work 18 hours sometimes. And then when we arrive to our houses, we have different ways for that. We have TV, we have the social media, we have a lot of things that creates the perfect state for being in a chronic inflammation that we call low-grade inflammation. And behind that, we can have different diseases. That's why we always recommend that. Basically, what we do when we fast is that we respect a different process that we have in the intestine, for example, is a specific mechanism that we clean our body. So when we are resting, when we are fasting, what we do is improve that functions of cleaning. And we have the capacity after a specific hours of time of fasting, we create something that we call autophagia. Autophagia is in Spanish, that we eat ourselves. How? So we try to find all the cells that are old and they're not functioning correct way, and we eliminate that cells. And as well, if we have some amino acids that they're not working because they lose the structure after a period, we lose the structure of the amino acids. What the body can do is get that amino acids and recycle that for creating a new proteins and new tissues. So we need time for do that. We cannot do it in 8 hours of fasting. We need to do it in after basically between 48 or 72 hours. We do that specific change in our metabolism. If we reduce the peaks of insulin, because we eat many times, when we eat, we create a peak of glucose. After that peak, we create a peak of insulin. And the most that you have different peaks or many peaks of insulin in our body, we create more inflammation. So the idea is to reduce that, And not only that, we suggest to change the kind of food. If we eat things that create inflammation, like sugars or different, I don't know, the different stuff that we can have the index, glucose index very high, very fast, so we create that inflammation state. So the idea is just to eat in a specific moment, increase the glucose slowly, and then getting down. This is the correct way of working with our metabolism. Instead to have those peaks and goals and ups and downs, that's very inflammatory state that we can get eating in that way. Basically, behind all the low-grade inflammation, we have everything. For example, insomnia. For example, having a very a lot of fluctuations in our emotions. Problems with the glucose, like metabolic syndrome, like diabetes type 2, that is very frequent nowadays, obesity, and the hypertension as well. We can reduce problems that we can have in a cognitive aspect as well. Nowadays, when we see the statistics, we see that we have a lot of depression, for example, or different psychiatric syndromes. But with this, we need just to keep in mind that we have a very important axis between the communication in the brain and the guts, the intestine. So reducing and having clean our intestine, we can work directly in the nervous system. So it's important for that. And cancer as well. So the way that we eat nowadays, if we can ask, we have in 10 people that we can be here in a group, maybe one we can have cancer. And part of that is because the lifestyle. Not only that, but it's very important thing, no? Is that inflammatory and oxidation state of our cells that we create cancer, for example. So behind the low-grade inflammation, we have most of the diseases that we have, arthritis, pain, chronic pain. So we need to reduce that cytokines that creates those problems. And this is a perfect way to do it. Of course, we can do many things. That's the idea, that you can do those things in our place, in the different places in your house. Basically, we need to food in different. We need to eat in different way. How? Reducing the amount. Why we eat more right now? Because we have resistance to something that is the leptin. And we have that problem because we eat more. The more that you eat, the more that you have fat, the more that you have sensibility to the leptin. So reducing the amount of the food is one thing. Reducing the number of meals, just eating one, two, or three. It's totally different than we heard in the past, that we need to eat 5 or 6 times. This is not physiologically. So eating less meals in a day. How can we do it? Very easily, because if we have an intermittent fasting, if we don't eat for 12 hours, 16 hours or 18 hours, it's very difficult that in that short period, in 6 or 8 hours, we can eat more than 2 meals. Another way is choosing the good food. We have different foods, some that are pro-inflammatory, like all that has a lot of sugars with high glycemic index, and the fat, the quality of the fat. We have fat that are pro-inflammatory, like trans fat or a specific saturated fat. And we have a very important in good fats that we should take, and they are anti-inflammatory, like they have omega-3 with different seaweeds, seeds, nuts, avocado, eggs, olive oil, all the ecological oils that we can have. This is important in our food. Another way is respecting the biorhythm. So try to rest at night. It's very easy. If you see that the sun goes, you have to rest. So try to switch off all the screens when you see that the sun goes. And if you cannot do it for any reason, you can use some specific filters of light. In that way, you don't send the message to our brain that you have to continue with that activity. This is one way. It's important for that as well to have a good temperature in the room that you're going to rest. Not very hot, not very cold. So more or less between 18, 19 degrees is perfect for having a good rest. Not very hot. Another thing, important thing is in the morning when you wake up, is try to be with the sun. The exposure to the sun is quite important for create that information. 12 hours later, more or less, the production of the melatonin. So if you can wake up and do some exercises, physical exercises or breathing in your window, in your garden, in your terrace, or if you have, you have the forest very close to your house, you can do it. It will be very interesting. This. And another important thing to do is moving. Moving, and I always add, moving with your belly empty or with your stomach empty. So before breakfast, do some exercises. What kind of exercises? All that you can do, anything that you can do. But basically, talking about the chronic process and the inflammatory process that we are trying to reduce is with the activation of our muscles. So power exercises, not only walking or swimming, we should do something with heavies, for example. Not very long, just doing 7 minutes, 8 minutes in a day, 3-4 times in a week is very interesting. And if you can do it in the morning before breakfast, is awesome. And of course, treating the emotional aspect. We need to reduce that rhythm. We need to reduce the stress. So with breathing exercises, visiting the forest, it's quite interesting what the forest and the trees can do for us. And for example, if you need, because you really have a stress and you cannot control, you can do yoga, meditation, and use some supplements that are really important to reduce that activity of the sympathetic nervous system that creates that state of stress in inflammation as well. So reducing that. So with these very easy topics, I think that you can recover your health, or if you have a good health, just keep it, because it's quite important. I hope that you enjoyed this video and you can get some topics for your normal life and change your lifestyle. If you decide to visit us, we're here in Marbella in Spain, and please follow us in our channel. Thank you very much and goodbye.